Hi, welcome to BPTV, and today we are going to be showing you the featurette of the fall play. We're here at the Bethel Park High School with Courtney Williams and all her students putting together another fabulous fall play for you. This year it is called The Heist. It has a lot of Bethel Park history to it, so I think you're going to enjoy this play as much as I'm looking forward to it. So today, take a look, watch how hard these students work, from your stage crew, through the actors, through the producers, through everything. Courtney, of course, does a marvelous job putting together these plays. So stay tuned, see how hard these kids are working, and come on out and see the play. Courtney, we're here at the high school. It's in time for another fall play. So why don't you start by telling us about this year's play?
This year's fall play is called The Heist. It is based on the first armored car robbery that happened here in the nation, and it happened here in Bethel Park at the intersection of Brightwood Road and Route 88. The play, it's a cautionary tale, and it's a fictionalized version of events that essentially lead up to this very real robbery.
This year's fall play is also really interesting. It was again written by our director, Mrs. Williams, and it is historical fiction based on the 1927 Brinks armored car robbery here in Bethel Park. So it's been a lot of fun to do because it has so many links to the area around us. So we're talking about places in the play, and we all know exactly where it is. It's places we've been, it's places we probably pass by on a daily basis.
Certainly in terms of the historical significance, the true person that was involved in the play, his name was Paul Jaworski, and he and eight other members, they called themselves the Flathead Gang, and they essentially staged the robbery on March 11th, 1927. And essentially what they did was they dug two landmines in the road and they blew up the armored cars from the bottom. And once they blew up the cars, the blast was so incredible that if you see old pictures, you see that one car is in a giant ditch. Another car was completely upside down with the impact of the explosions. And essentially it really didn't end there. That with Jaworski, he went on and had a bit of a criminal life after the 1927 robbery. But oddly enough, he was captured at a Bentleyville farm about 2 days later. Inadvertently, someone had seen them going to the farmhouse and they caught Paul Jaworski. They didn't know who he was at the time. He'd given a fake name. But that particular group with Jaworski, they had robbed the Mollenauer mine the year before on Christmas Eve. And so this wasn't the first time that they had hit Bethel Park. It was the second time that they had hit Bethel Park. Jaworski later was electrocuted in 1929 for his parts in robberies, for several deaths that he was involved in. And it was actually the death of a gentleman by the last name of Gump, who was killed at the Mollenauer robbery, that eventually caused Jaworski to be sent to the electric chair in 1929.
Well, how much research did you put into this?
I did a lot of research in terms of looking out to old articles, reaching out to some people such as Bill Haberther at the Historical Society, and trying to get as much information about the instance as possible. And so it provided the framework as to what had happened on that particular day. Now again, because it is a fictionalized version, many of the events that fill in there were things that I had brought together to lead up to the robbery.
Jack came to the company store because he needed coffee.
Yes, I was driving along and I suddenly realized I was out of coffee, so I stopped at the store to get some coffee, and that's how I met Rose.
I sold him coffee.
You wrote this yourself.
I did.
And in writing it yourself, this has to be a tremendous amount of work. So not only in rehearsals and out with the students, you started this probably even before last year's fall play was done.
That's actually not correct. Okay. I started this particular play right when we finished school, so June 15th. And so I worked for about 10 hours a day for about 5 weeks in order to put the play together, and then there's always rereads going back to it. It takes me about a week to block the play, all of the staging involved in the play. So it was a very compressed period of time that I had to get it all together for.
Very busy summer then.
I was very busy.
We're just changing because I have to go talk to Jeff, and Kim, and I just can't be together for this.
And that's good. That's good that you change a little bit. Just make sure you're 2-2. And Alex, when you come over here with them, you're not going to get a cup.
Dang it.
We always hand him a cup because we're like, yeah.
He's cool.
Don't give him a cup.
Tell me your thought process that made you pick a play like this. This is different.
This is very different. Part of the thought process, as always, is trying to highlight as many students as possible in the production, and also trying to incorporate as many community members, as many community entities in Bethel Park. And so it seemed a great way to incorporate a little bit of Bethel Park history in kind of a unique way this year.
Well, I noticed with the crew, you have a large crew this year.
Yes.
A lot of students and a lot of stage crew, technical support and everything with the play this year.
Yes, it's nice. I believe there's somewhere over 60 members of stage crew.
Wow.
We have 28 members in our cast this year, so we have lots of students involved. So it's wonderful that so many kids come out and share their talent.
Does it make it harder to do a production with that many students?
Well, there's always a challenge when you have lots of people involved, but to be honest, it's great to have so many kids that want to share their time. And so, you know, and that creative process as we're meshing together, you know, with working with a lot of people at once, that the kids, they come together really well. And so at the end of the day, I just think it's fantastic. And that's why I try to look for plays that incorporate as many cast members, as many crew members as possible, because if they're interested in performing and they're interested in working behind the scenes, then I'm so glad to have their help and have them share their talent.
My name is Graydon Tomkowitz. I am a senior at Bethel Park, and I am playing the role of Georgie Davis.
I think it's the Pirates' year this year. I think they're going to take the series again like they did back in 26.
Can any team beat the Yankees?
That Pirate rookie, Paul Wehner, was third in the league in slugging percentage last year.
So Georgie is the only son in the Davis family, which is the family that the heist centers on. And he works in a coal mine, but his real dream in life is to be a professional baseball player. And that's really what moves the plot of the heist forward, is Georgie's desire to play Major League Baseball and how that affects his choices.
If I had looked out for myself, I never would have gotten hurt. Perhaps it's time now to start looking out for yourself.
It's exactly what I intend to do from now on.
I think we might be able to help each other, George.
The reason why I'm really enjoying it this year is just, I love all of the people in Fall Play. It's mm-hmm. such a great group of people. We call it the Fall Play family. And then also with that hometown connection with the play this year, with the play taking place in Bethel Park, all of the local landmarks being referenced, it's a lot of fun to perform because it's so much easier to understand your character when you understand where the character comes from.
Leo really wants to talk to Georgie about the Pirates.
That's nice. I'm sure you boys will enjoy your baseball talk.
Yeah, we'll enjoy talking about baseball.
Why'd you hit me?
Because I haven't told Mama that Leo thinks the Johnnies might be interested in signing me this season.
My name is Ryan Merkel. I'm in 10th grade, and I'm playing Leo. Well, Leo is a current baseball player for a C-League team, and he's the one that offers Georgie a chance to play for the Johnsonville Johnnies and kind of sets a lot of the show into motion.
Our pitcher started having some trouble at the end of last season, and I've been telling the coach and manager about that arm of yours. They're interested in adding you to our lineup, but they want to see you pitch a game or two before making an offer.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Hallman. I'm playing the part of Rosie Davis, and I am a senior at Bethel Park High School. She's definitely the sassy member of the family, always looking for trouble and looking for a little bit of excitement. She wants to go to New York, though she's stuck here in Bethel Park, and her real goal is just to get out of here. She doesn't want to be here, and so she's going to make that happen for herself any way that she can.
When you were 16, you got married and had Georgie at 17. I'm old enough to make my own decisions.
I just don't want you to get hurt.
Yours, Mama's right.
You're just jealous because a handsome, well-dressed man asked me out and brought me flowers.
Oh, Rose, I'm not jealous. I'm just concerned.
I think it's going to be great. I think it's very exciting. There's a lot of twists and turns in the plot, and it's not something like we've done in the past. It's definitely a lot more drama, and it's a lot more intense.
How did you find where I lived?
I just asked around for where Rosie lived, prettiest girl in town.
Oh, you're too much, Jack.
You let him call you Rosie? You hate it when people call you that.
It sounds better when Jack says it.
So, Rose, you never mentioned Jack before. Where did the two of you meet?
I met Rose
yesterday, when he came to the company store.
I'm Natalia Kowiak, and I'm a senior at Bethel Park High School. And this year, I'm Lizzie Davis in this year's show. Lizzie is the oldest Davis sister. She's a few years older than Rose, maybe one. And she is very composed, and she's smart. She's a secretary, and she and Rose get in a lot of conflicts because Rose is kind of jealous of her. And Rose, like, wants to go to New York, and she feels like Lizzie is more successful and stuff. And then Lizzie also has, like, a romantic interest in one of the other mine boys, Georgie's best friend, William.
So maybe, like, I'll just try to take longer, and I'll get, like, I'll get Harry's coat for him, too, or something. And then I'll say goodnight, William, when they're both there.
Or just pretend like you're talking.
My name's Austin Carver. I'm in 12th grade, and I'm playing William. William is George's best friend. He works in the mine with Harry and Charlie, and he tries to guide William throughout the play to get him to make the right decisions.
You can move in here, and because you work in the mine, they can keep the house, and I can send home money to help out.
Whoa. I think you're putting the cart way before the horse, Georgie. Lizzie and I haven't even gone on a date yet. Don't you have a reading date tomorrow?
We do, but I wasn't planning to propose.
I'm Zach Janis. I'm a junior, and I play Harry. Harry works a lot with Jack, William, and Charlie. He's kind of like the guide of Charlie. He works in the mine, and he's just an overall funny character.
Ready? Let's do some mining.
I do leave.
Whoa!
I'm very much enjoying this year.
Why?
Oh, just like the cast is great, Miss Foss is great, the historical aspect of this play, phenomenal. It's just overall great.
My name is Santino. I'm a freshman here, and I play the part of Charlie. Charlie is a 14-year-old who hangs out with Georgie, William, and Harry, and he tries to act a lot older than he is, around 16 or 17, because there is an age requirement to work in the mine, and he lied to his boss to get in there so his family could have the wage for the mine. And, you know, he's always acting like an adult, and he's an equal of his friends.
Charlie, don't work too hard. Next shift can finish for us.
Harry, you're just worried that I'll work you and they'll promote me.
Yeah, that'll never happen, kid.
Okay, I'll remember those words when I'm your boss.
I'm Abby Carrick. I'm a junior here at Bethel Park, and I play Mama Davis. So she's a single mother of six kids. In the 1920s, that's, like, normal, but it's still, like, really difficult for her to keep up the household and stuff.
Yes, your father was a handsome man, but he was a good man inside and out. Something tells me that man Jack is nothing but trouble.
It's a lot different than I'm used to because it's, like, a very dramatic part, and she has to deal with a lot throughout the show, especially with her only son, Georgie. So she has to go through a lot, and that's been a different experience to act.
I'm Madison Miller. I'm a senior at Bethel Park High School, and my role is Annie Davis. I am the youngest of the Davis sisters, so I'm, like, Georgie's younger sister, Rose's younger sister, and, like, Lizzie's, and, yeah. I kind of just do chores around the house. It's neat to do something that was, like, from Bethel Park, because, like, the last couple years we did, like, Peter Pan and Robin Hood, and then last year we did the second act theater, and, like, it's just different to do something, and it's cool to do something that's, like, from, like, your hometown.
I'm Sydney Watson. I'm a senior, and I play Mae Davis.
Someday, when I become a famous archaeologist, you'll be glad to tell people that you're my sister, Mae. The only archaeological dig site that you will ever need is that coal mine. Just wait. Someday, I'm going to go to Egypt, and I'm going to discover something like the Rosetta Stone.
May is the middle daughter of the Davis family, and she wants to be an archaeologist when she grows up, which was really, it was very unusual for back in that time period, so I think she's really cool.
Hi, I'm Sarah Pellis. I'm a junior, and I play Louise Davis. I'm one of Georgie's, like, younger little sisters, and I'm always with Annie Davis, and we're pretty much doing chores around the house and helping our mom out pretty much.
Okay.
And just observing quietly and eavesdropping on everything that's happening pretty much. So.
So you want Leo to wait until Saturday night to come here?
No, this is the last place that I would want to talk to Leo about the Johnnies. The girls would still be here. The girls are here, I might as well just tell Mom that they're always eavesdropping.
Why do you want Leo to meet you then?
About the Waterman Hotel.
My name is Cameron Carroll. I'm playing Jack Malovic, and I am a senior now. So I am the antagonist in the play. He's actually largely based upon the real character of Paul Jaworski, who was involved in the real armed car robbery. So he's one of my favorites, personally, that I've played thus far because he's just so dimensional. And he has so many different sides to him.
Owen George, I'm going to need you to bring that information that we talked about.
What do you need George's help for?
A business opportunity.
I think people should come see this because you really get to understand the history of Bethel Park. I don't think people really appreciate the value that we have here in Bethel Park and the richness of the community.
I don't want to get caught either, George. We won't get caught. How do you know? Because we didn't get caught before.
My name is Abby Colts. I am in 12th grade, and my part is Albert.
Sabrina Myers, grade 11, and I play Martha and Frank.
Lauren Mondell, Jr., and Fred.
My name is Cam Solman. I'm in 11th grade, and I play Clyde, one of the robbers.
I'm Blake McGee. I'm a junior, and I'm playing Eddie, one of the robbers in the gang.
My name is Anna McClose. I'm in 11th grade.
I am Tony, news reporter number one, and the student director.
Well, Albert's one of the robbers, and yeah, it's pretty cool. You know, he's one of the ones that helps steal some getaway cars, so that's fun.
Tony is one of the robbers, and he helps out Jack, and he sort of has this feud with Frank.
He's, like, part of the comic relief for the play. Like, him and the rest of the gang are always just, like, messing around and goofing about in the background, and their main goal is just to rob the truck and get away with the money.
Frank is one of the robbers. He's the one who makes the bombs that blow up the truck. He kind of knows his way around the explosives.
I'm one of Jack's gang, so I just help with the robbery.
I'm really just one of, like, Jack's lackeys. I kind of just do whatever he says.
It's fun to be one of the characters who's actually one of the most historically accurate, because the most historically accurate are the gang of robbers and the leader. So it's kind of cool to be someone who might have actually existed.
I think it's good that they should be educated on some of the older history of Bethel Park, since, you know, this is an event that not many people know about. It's also a very good story. I really, really like the play that we're putting on this year.
I already checked out a place in Mount Lebanon for the block powder, but the guy wanted me to fill out all kinds of paperwork. I said forget about it.
Yeah, paperwork will leave a trail.
We definitely don't want to leave no trail.
I didn't even know you could read, Frank.
If you're so smart, Tony, why'd you get Nick living the wallet off a cop?
It was a dare.
Yeah? Well, I dare you to be smarter next time, Tony.
Yeah?
I dare you to go to the first lunch next time.
That's enough, boys. You don't need to fight drawing attention to us.
Sorry, Jack.
My name is Alexander Antkoviak, and I'm in grade 9.
Okay.
And I am the bartender, and I am police officer number 2.
My name is Kelly Catullius. I'm a 9th grader here at the Bethel Park High School, and I'm news reporter number 3. News reporter number 3 makes an appearance at the end, and only the end, and reports on what happened with the crime. I'm also a police officer in one of the very first scenes, and I am a hotel patron at the Waterman Hotel.
My name is Violetta Bernardi. I'm in 9th grade, and I play a police officer and a background in the Waterman Hotel.
My name is Abby Flaherty. I am in 9th grade, and I am news reporter number 4, a background police officer, and a background in the Waterman Hotel.
My name is Gabby Johnson, and I'm one of the guards.
My name is Macy Ranko. I'm in grade 9, and I'm a guard and in the background.
Okay, are you excited with your roles?
Yes, I like my roles. They're really fun to play.
I'm Alex Carver, and I'm in 9th grade, and I'm a police officer.
In talking to some of the actors making this featurette, they seem very excited about what's going on. And none of them would tip their hat as far as any of the special effects or anything for it. But it's fun seeing how excited the students are too. That's fun. That's encouraging.
And the kids are awesome.
The cast is so fantastic. I'm so, so, so proud of them. They've worked so hard for months, and they're continuing to work hard as we get ready for their performances. And so I appreciate that they are students first, but every day they come here and they are actors and actresses and they put their time in. And now that we are joining with stage crew, they are technical theater people who are, again, students, technical theater people who are bringing their talents to their after school, and they're willing to donate that time and to be a part of something. And I'm very thankful that they are, and I'm glad that they're excited, because I'm excited for them.
Well, there's definitely more people this year and a lot more costume changes, and we have to be accurate because of the time period. That's another big thing, because it's set in the 20s, and last year we had modern day, so it was kind of easy. A lot of people brought in their own clothes.
My name is Molly Keurig, and I am 16. I'm a junior, and I am assistant stage manager for the fall play, The Heist. Basically, my job is to tell the grips, which are the people that move the stuff off and on the stage, when to go and when to come off. There's a lot of props for this show, so my grips do a really great job at doing their job, and I'm very proud of them.
Start taking the stuff into the hallway.
I'm Matthew Nessler, and I'm the sound designer for The Heist. I'm a senior here, and I'm in charge of making the mic charts and kind of all the paperwork and the leading of the sound crew. I'm kind of the problem solver, so if anything goes wrong, I kind of I'm there to fix it and to take notes on potential problems. And specific for this for the heist here is we're running our sound a little bit differently, just with the way we run some things, just to see how it works out.
I'm Logan Huey, and I'm lighting designer for the heist. So basically I just like design the lights, and like, so somebody like on show night, they just have to like press buttons, so like nothing gets messed up. It's just like already done.
Certainly with this play, it did require some additional thinking about how to add some more special effects, some different techniques to the play in terms of staging. Some are always, of course, caused by that we're using a stage, and so we're trying to make things as realistic as possible within that context. I mean, at the end of the day, it's a stage, and so we're always trying to find innovative ways to make it feel more realistic, to make it feel that the audience is more interested or excited about the play. And so that is certainly coming through that lighting, through our sound, and also through some of the props that we're going to use this year. And so in some aspects, it's a more technically difficult play than we've done in other years. And so it does require more from the students as well, and from those behind the scenes students. There's a lot of props, there's a lot of scene changes. And so to make all of those happen and keep the play going, those students are doing a great job of making that flow happen.
Well, they're acting, they're enjoying themselves, but more than ever before, I see them actually learning while you're doing this play this year.
And we're so lucky. We really have an excellent music department, theater department here at Bethel Park High School. John Derby, who works with stage crew, he does a wonderful job with teaching students, with getting them involved, with getting them, because the students run the show. So it's not the adults that are doing the cues. It's not the adults that are placing the props. It's all student run. And so they are learning, and they are obviously doing as part of this program.
So Courtney, tell us, the viewers, the community, why should they come out and see this, or what can they expect when they come out and see this?
The Bethel Park community should come to see a fantastic show that students have worked for months to put together, to see the talents that are here in young people, to see the wonderful things that they are able to accomplish. And so I really hope that the audience is as excited as the actors and actresses and the technical crew are, to put on the show, to see the show, to be a part of the show. So we really want to include them, and we really hope that they leave the show and have enjoyed it and have taken away something from our little bit of theater here.
This has been amazing. It has blown every expectation out of the water.
This feels like a second home when I'm here during the fall, and it really gets me in the spirit of getting back to school and starting my next year and finally my last year.
We've put so much effort and heart into this, and it's really special because Miss Williams wrote it, and we love it. We love to be here, and you guys would love to see it.
It's just going to be neat to see something, especially if you're from Bethel Park, to see like something that happened in your hometown so long ago, to us bring it back to life on the stage.
If you have a strong historical like drive in you, I'd say come out and see it. It'll get your drive going, and it'll be just an overall great time.
Mrs. Williams is doing a fantastic job, like always. She's amazing, and she puts so much work into this.
I love this play because it's just so personal, because it's like here, it's set here in Bethel Park, so like that's just so much different than like any other show we've done.
It's really exciting. You're going to be surprised, and there's a lot of plot twists.
There are a couple plot twists that you don't really see coming, and they kind of tug on your heartstrings, and it's kind of sad a couple times, but you should really come and see it. It's going to be an amazing show.
Be sure to come see it. It's going to be a great time.
Courtney, any final closing thoughts or comments that you wish to make?
There are so many people to thank who are involved in this production. I have to start with Anne-Marie Hastings, who brings her costuming talent, her husband Jim. Even though their daughter graduated 2 years ago, they're still here helping out every year. I also, of course, have to thank Dr. Jansani and Mrs. Frazier and Dr. Pascarilla for their continued support of Bethel Park students in their theatrical endeavors. We have so many members of the community who support us, such as Evie Hardware and Brookside Lumber, Quilter's Corner, Five Star Tire, and Supreme Cleaners. Mr. Andy Amerine and the Education Foundation for their support through the Bethel Park Essay and Art Contest this year. Mrs. Christine McIntosh and the library staff for their help with the Art and Essay Contest, and of course Mr. Haberther at the Bethel Park Historical Society, Mr. Amerine and Mr. Cable for consistently helping through the Bethel Park Fall Featurette every year. Rick Seaback, who took an interest and featured us in his Route 88 show as well. And of course, John Derby and Stage Crew. Where would we be without the magic that Stage Crew provides? And I also have to thank my family, my parents, Judy and Bill Falls, who, even though their kids all grown up, they're still being pulled in to help with Bethel Park endeavors, and my husband, David, who is my dramaturg, who I go to for all my help and suggestions, and who is my man behind the scenes with all of this. So there's so many people that I'm so thankful for all of their help, and my wonderful cast and the wonderful stage crew. Thank you. The play of the Heist will run November 9th to November 11th. Tickets are $5, and they are available at the door each night of the show at Bethel Park High School Auditorium.
I know as a resident, I'm very much looking forward to seeing the play, and I'll be here every night, front row, seeing what you and your actors are doing. So thank you for taking the time, and thank you for writing the play, and break a leg.
Thank you very much.
Wow. You know, I'm almost speechless for how hard these kids work. What a great show that these kids are going to put together. I can't wait to see the finished product. I always love getting a little bit of a preview. Fortunate enough to be up here at the high school seeing what these kids are putting together, how hard they're working. Thank you for watching again on BPTV, and I hope you come out to the high school and enjoy the show.